Mortex here, and today's video is all about Duckstation, the new PS1 emulator. I'm going to show you how to get it set up and running so you can play some classic PS1 games on the PC. So the first thing we need to do, as always, is download where the software comes from. So I put the link in the description down below, so go there and download it. It will bring you up onto this page. We've got the latest development build. It was updated roughly 4 days ago. We've got all the patch notes here if you do want to read about that. But the main thing we want to go down to is assets. We want to click straight onto the Windows assets. What's also good about this, it actually runs on various other platforms. So we've got Android, Mac and Windows. So once we've downloaded this, extract it as normal. I've got it on the desktop, and this is our main space that we're going to be focusing on. The front ends, you've got two different versions of the front ends. I'm just going to get them up and show you here. This is the one that I prefer. It's a lot more slick and stylish, but we do have a bare bones version as well. So whichever you prefer, it doesn't matter, but I'm going to stick with the first one because I just prefer it a lot more. Before we can even get started and play any games, we need to make sure we got the BIOS files correctly installed in the BIOS folder. If you haven't got BIOS files, you're not going to be able to play any PS1 games. We're going to go straight into settings, BIOS files, and then we're going to find the directory. Now the directory will already be highlighted here. Mine is in e:/duckstation/bios. I've already installed the BIOS, as you can see here. And then the next thing we are going to do is install our ROM directory. Now I would highly recommend putting a ROM folder in here. Once you've done that, let's go back into the settings. Then we need to go on to game lists. So as you can see, mine is set up differently because I've got my ROMs on the desktop. But all you would do is go into a hard search directory, find where your folder is put in the Duckstation folder, and then click it as allocated to there. So that's where all the ROMs will be. If you've got an alternative folder where your ROMs are kept, then just find it and allocate it to that. Once that's done, you've pretty much got the emulator up and running and you can play PS1 games straight away. But there is some tinkering that we need to do first. So if you are using a wireless controller, let's say like an Xbox controller, you do need to configure this. So the first thing we'll do is go onto control settings. Now, even though it's a digital controller, I'd always recommend putting the force popping control mode. And then all we're going to do is map these buttons. Once we've done that, it's all set up and good to go. Now, the next thing we are going to go on to is emulation settings. Now, I've got this set to 100%, which is fine and dandy. Now, you can go all the way up to 600 frames per second. Don't ask me why you'd want to do it, but you can actually do that. I just keep this all set as normal. We've got fast forward speed and turbo speed as normal. We've got enable rewinding as well. I would highly recommend doing this because if you ever fail a part of a level, you can always rewind like you can in RetroArch. You can set the time frames and the seconds as well. Now we're going to go on to memory settings. Now memory settings is a bit of a strange one really, I find in this. You can actually have separate cards for each game, which I would highly recommend, and it's defaultly set at. Alternatively, if you want to go back to the retro era and put all your saves on one memory card and find out when you get to a crucial save point, you haven't got any space and you can't save it, then you can do this. I wouldn't recommend it, but if you want to get that retro feel, by all means, go ahead and do that. And the next setting is display settings, which we need to look into. Now we've got various options. We've got OpenGL, we've got Vulkan. Normally I stick with Vulkan and then enable VSync. I would always recommend doing this. Various other settings for the aspect ratio, crop ratio. There's numerous things you can do in this. I'm not going to deep dive into it because we just want to get you up and running straight away. I always put show games SPS, you know, because I like to see the SPS for me. Now the main one we need to focus on is enhance settings. Now there's various settings here. The main one that you want to focus on is this internal resolution scale. Now you can scale it up to whatever you want. Whatever the screen size is, you can just go automatic, or you can do 1080p, 720p, 1440 or 4k. I've just got it at 1080p, you know, that's the way I like to play it and that's the way I'm going to keep it, but you can experiment and try different things. There's a lot of different settings here to make the textures and the gameplay a lot smoother and seem a lot more crisp. I would recommend playing around with some of these as well. Now, audio settings, pretty plain and simple. All I'm going to say is if you are getting audio problems with the game buffering, come into the buffering size, take it down a notch or put it up a notch and see if that works. Make sure you've got sync to output on as well, because this should stop all the audio issues. Now, hotkeys, as I mentioned earlier, we've got the fast forward and rewind buttons. If you come to a boss fight and you did something wrong and you died and you don't want to get back to that save point, you can just rewind it 10 seconds or how many seconds you've set it on the emulator and you'll be straight back into the action. So that's basically the interface. As I said, there's a lot more that we could go in depth in this, but I just want to get you up and running so you can play some PS1 games. So there you have it, guys. That is a quick setup of how to get Duckstation up and running on your PC so you can play some of them classic PS1 games. Now, this software goes really in depth. We've only just covered the basis because I didn't want to get too in depth today, but there's some really neat things you can actually do this once you start looking into it. I've been using this for the last couple of months, and I've got to say it's one of the best PS1 emulators that you can find on the market today. I've also got a video down below in the corner as well. As you can see, I'm actually running it on the Android as well, and it does fare pretty well. I'm running it on a Huawei P10, so it is a pretty old device, but as you can see here, it runs pretty smooth, and I have got it running at 1080p as well. And guys, let me know what you think about this in the comments. What is your favorite PS1 emulator? What is your favorite PS1 game? Do you like Duckstation or don't you? And let me know why. And as always, guys, we have got various other content down below in the video, and we have got a lot of stuff coming in the next few months. If you want to see anything on the channel, let me know in the comments below, because I am all ears. And if you could please like this video, that'd be amazing. But until next time, guys, stay safe, and I'll see you soon.